My name is Paulo Oliveira. I'm the second author of this talk, Interlocking Virtual as a Tool for Students. This work was partially done by Diogo Ramos. He's a master's degree student in electrical engineering. He's finishing now, he's over there, he's going to answer the questions. And so I'm from UTI University and from the NESTEC Research. So, the structure of the presentation is this one. I'm going to begin to do a small introduction and motivation for this work. Then I'm going to speak about MIT EPA Venton, some key issues, the development of applications for teaching and learning automation and feedback control systems. Then I'm going to speak about two applications, that is the theme of the paper, is teach to student and student to teach. Some preliminary results, and then conclusion and future, current future work. Okay. So, from my experience as a lecturer, there is a strong connection between students and mobile devices. I think this is obvious, and this photo that I put here is a common scene, that you can find students using mobile devices like smartphones inside and outside the classrooms. And this is constant, it's intensive, and I think you can look at this in two ways. Either you can fight against it, or maybe try to use it in your own advantage. So, I think that mobile applications will be a very, very common tool for teaching, as now are so other technologies. So, I think students also are very ready to use these technologies. I don't know about the lectures, but students, they are ready. So, after realizing this, and the question that I pose is, okay, as a lecturer who doesn't know much about programming or developing mobile applications, how fast can a teacher with no specific knowledge about programming learn to do an application and use these technologies? This is the question that I put to myself, and the answer for this question for me and for now, I think, is the MIT App Inventor. So why? Because with no specific knowledge about programming, just the very basics, you can do very easily an application. The only limitation that we already see here is that these applications are only for Android systems. Okay. So, why using the MIT App Inventor? Maybe for two things. First, because the interface is very easy to use. It got two options. One is for designing the interface. So it has is based on the blocks. A drag and drop. You can drag and drop the several elements, several knowledge. So it's very easy. And after you design the application, then you can program what the objects are going to do. Also with a very easy programming technology based on blocks. So you don't have syntax problems. It's quite easy to use. Okay. So. It is impressive, since the time that you begin to use the App Inventor to the time that you are testing the application is really, really fast. So, like, if you follow the first tutorial, you can have the first application for testing in like half an hour. Why? Because it has several ways to download applications. One of those that you also can use in the classroom is with a QR code that it generates, and the students can scan it straight away. So after discovering and learning how to use this application, I try to say, okay, how can I use this to teach automation and control subjects? So I developed some applications. The first one, it was that one I call Logicon. The second is Automaton, and the third one is modeling ecosystems. These are very easy applications that I'm going just to pass some slides to see what they do. The first one, I call it Logicon, is an application to teach the very basics of logical Boolean logic. So it's nothing very extraordinary, because there's a lot of applications for this. So I just pick up and design interface to teach the very easy, like the AND function, the OR function, the NOT function, the exclusive OR function, and then some non-Boolean functions like this for trigger and edges, and some information, okay? So the objective here is to, okay, first present the mathematical expressions, then see what is an electrical circuit representation of the mathematical expressions, do a simple animation, and a ladder diagram example. So this is one example for the OR operator. So you can see, like in the top, like the mathematical, the symbols, the mathematical, the truth table, the electrical circuit, and two switches where they can try to see what happened. And in this case, you have to switch one, well, just to turn one of the switches on to turn the light on, and then you can see what is the analogy between the circuit, the mathematics, and also the ladder diagrams. The ladder diagrams are used to teach programming for programmable logical controllers. It's one of the most used language. So this is like the basic, is a kind of tool they can use to see, okay, background review, to see if they understand what are the relations between logic and circuits and ladder diagrams, okay? So I got another expression for the exclusive OR operator, the same thing. And this one, next one is, I call it automaton, is a more complex, more elaborate application, where I provide some several things, like for instance, topic for the classes, some quizzes, problems, tutorials, and some information, okay? This is in Portuguese. So I try to see, okay, how can I use these easy tutorials from the App Inventor? How can I adapt them to my own purpose? So I, for instance, I put some quizzes where I have some questions and they can test if they know to solve the problem. For instance, in a graph state structure, as you have over there, what are the possibilities of evolution in that structure? Okay, there are several options, and they can try and see if the answer is right or wrong. Okay, this is a kind of quiz, and also they can see the answer. It's a simple application. I have done more with specific questions for programming, in this case for timers, for the PLC programming as well. Where they can see if they understood really how a timer works. Also for simple animations with overlapping pictures, you can do some animations frame by frame, and they can use it to simulate, like for instance in this case, the relation between a model, a graph set model, and then the system, the didactic system with a car, and then the PLC input and output that you can see over there. You see, this is the system, this is the graph set model, and this is like the PLC, and then you can see what is the relation between what is happening in the car, what is happening in the model that represents the controller here, and also in the PLC. Okay? Also, I put some problems that can solve in their own time, that's more or less more like this. In this one, the model control system, this is more for biomedical engineering. This is like the basic concepts of control. This is like just to have the things in that smartphone, okay? So this is like the background, and now for this particular paper, this teacher to student and student to teacher, the idea was really very simple. Okay, because students are messing all the time with mobile phones. So I had this crazy idea of, why? Maybe I can find an application when students finishing their window of adaptation, like 20 minutes, maybe I can post them information about some key issues in the about the lecture. So really the idea is that is have an application for teachers where they can program and post to students key issues about each class, okay? Key issues, key questions, and the teacher can do this beforehand or in the class and then send it to a database. And students can reach that information as well, and also can assess specific tutorial quizzes that the teacher can do, okay? This is like the idea, and one thing that I want to show you is the graphical interface that you are going to see here is not the same as in the paper, because it was improved since. I'm going to speak first about teacher to student. This is the login screen. The teacher has to register, your kind of registration, and after that you can manage until a maximum of 4 simultaneous courses. Okay? For in this one, I just put one course, is automation, register and automation. Okay, this is my the course that I want to see. Then I switch that, and then I can, for each class, I can put or insert until a maximum 5 posts per class. Okay? We can insert the post, see the class number, insert the post, and edit the post, and send the post for the database. Okay? So, also, I can do two types of quizzes, a true and false quiz and a multiple choice quiz. They are the only options so far. So, for the quizzes, we just have to insert the questions, for instance, until 5 questions, and to insert the right answer, true or false. Or in the case of a multiple choice, you have to put the question and then all the possible answers, okay? And say what is the right and the wrong answer, okay? After you do this in the teacher to student application, you can also send it for the database and the students can reach it. So this is more or less the same thing with another one, and this is like just the student to teach. It's the opposite, where you can go and choose the posts, the quizzes, and the information. He has to select the course that he wants first, and after selecting the course, for a given lecture, you can see the posts, the quizzes, and the information. And this is for the industrial automation, this is my name, and he can change the posts for the classes. In this case, it will be the first class, and also it shows what was the last class that the teacher has inserted posters. Okay, so sorry, you can see here the posts. You can expand each post and see what are the posts. In this case, it was just a simple guidelines, but it can be questions, because students like it's a one way to reach students. It's okay. I'm going to give you the questions for the exam, and they like that. So you can post them, and that's a way of reaching them and they have their attention. And okay, for the quiz, it's the same. It's like they download the quiz and they can answer and test it if true or false or multiple choice. And this is like more or less the state of the thing. We have done because this was done in a very short period, so the young has finished the applications, and then I have we have done a questionnaire, and we have applied to an automation and control course for with 18 students, but only 9. But it's a very 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 small sample, so it is not significant, and only 9 of those had Android based phones. And they answer 11 questions, and these are the preliminary results. And okay, based on this sample, it is not significant. It was quite good, the feedback. The students like this. So they, I don't know, it was because I said, okay, if you don't put the positive answer, I'm going to fail you. But okay, they said, okay, it was quite good. And okay, so as a conclusion, I think that, in general, MIT AP Inventor is a very, very, very good tool for teaching. I think he's in a very early development. He got very limitations because for this application, it was okay. The programming was not so simple, and so the OS to think a little bit harder how to implement that in a block-based programming. But for the other applications, I think it's going to be very very useful, and it's very useful. And for these two applications, the feedback is so far is good. But I'm going to try it again now with more students in this year, and to really validate it. And for future work, as okay, this is done for me. I'm using it. While the three other applications I can just give them to you and you can use it. This one still is in a stage that we have to fix some problems with the database. That's the only thing that we have to sort it out, okay? I'm going to continue to do more experimentation with this thing, especially asking students in another context to develop their own application. Because I think students are eager to try this. That's my feedback from students. So I'm going to now in this year to not only test these ones, but continue and ask them to do assignments where the report is an application instead of a standard report. Okay. And more or less is this one. That's this thing I have to tell you. Thank you very much for your attention.